CBS presents this program in color.
Let's meet the Holtrust family. Steve, Pam, Ed, Julie, and Mark, ready for action. Playing against the Bracey family. Myra, Roberta, Billy, John, and Lee Ellen. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Coates.
Hello, America. Thank you so very much. Thank you. Thanks once again for joining us. We're having so much fun on The Feud. Everybody's watching. More and more people every day. I can't believe it. I thank you for joining us. We've got two wonderful families battling once again for $5,000. Our returning champions, the Holtrust family. It's good to have you,
thank you.
This family has won $13,577. This is your fifth day on the show, and it's unfortunately going to be your final day. We wish you well. I have not got the chance to ask you in 5 days, Ed, what do you do for a living?
We own a wedding chapel in Upland, California.
A wedding chapel?
Wedding chapel.
With your sizes, you just stop cars and you force them to come in and
right.
get married. You
That's
say,
right.
the folks are getting married. I got a theory. You've won five times, very strong. You're large people, proportionate, wonderful, good-looking large people. I think your brains are bigger than most people. I think that's the thing. Yeah, what's the shortest child you have?
Our youngest daughter, Lori, she's 5 foot seven.
Well, that's, she's just 5'10", all right. We'll argue about this later. We'll talk about it later. I wish you well. You have to beat this wonderful family, the Bracey family. Billy Bracey, welcome to our show. Now, who did you bring with you today to try to beat the champs?
Well, I brought a winning family. My sister, Myra.
I'm Myra.
My
Hi.
Sister, Lee Ellen.
Hi, Lee Ellen.
My sister, Roberta.
Hi, Roberta.
Brother-in-law, John.
John, you've got a wonderful accent. Welcome to our show. Now, where are you all from?
Well, we're all from Virginia originally.
Uh-huh.
And they lived out in Utah for a while, and we all live out in California, except for Myra. She still lives in Utah.
Okay, well, I wasn't getting that involved in it, Billy, but... I was just mainly concerned where you were from. You've got a great accent and a lovely family. I wish you well as you play the feud against the champions. Let's go. Good luck to both families. Please remember, the first family to reach $300 will win the game and get the chance to play Fast Money for $5,000. We asked 100 people this question, and the top six answers on the board try to find the most popular answer. If you're short of money, what's the one bill you're sure to pay? Billy.
Electric bill.
He says electric. How about electric? It is there, but one will beat it. Ed, can you give me that answer and take control of that board?
Hey, water bill.
He says water bill. Let us see water. It is not there. We go to the Bracey family. Ed, go back with your family. You may get that chance to steal. You certainly know how to do that. Hi, Myra.
Hi.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You're welcome. If you're short of money, what's the one bill you're sure to pay?
Your house payment.
House payment makes good sense to me. Let us see. Yeah. House payment. The number one answer. House payment, mortgage payment. Great start. 63 people in the survey agree. Hi, Lee Ellen.
How are you?
I'm just doing good. A lot better since you're here because you're so lovely.
Thank you.
But if you're short of money, what's the one bill you're sure to pay?
Your fuel bill.
Fuel.
All right.
Fuel. She says fuel. Yeah, Myra goes, yeah, that was good, that was good, yeah. I don't really believe you mean that, Myra. Let us see fuel bill. It's there, gas and heating. That surprised me. No strikes, you're on your way to a clean sweep. Welcome, Roberta.
Thank you. How about the telephone bill?
Telephone bill.
That's it.
All right, so you can call a bank to try to borrow money. How about the phone bill? It's there, number three. Uh-oh. Champions, these guys came to play. Hi, John, you're down
Howdy.
On the end here.
Yes.
There are two answers up there. If you're short of money, what's the one bill you're sure to pay?
A car.
You need a car to go to work so you can get some money. How about car? It's there. And you left one answer for Billy. Billy, if you can give me this answer, you're going to take control of that bank. You're going to take that money. You have no strikes.
Insurance.
He says insurance.
Yeah.
It's there you take the bank. If not, it's only your first strike. Insurance. You take the bank. The Gracie family strike first. How about that? $97 for the Gracies. The Holtrust shut out at this point, but we're going all the way to $300. The champs want to play once again for $5,000. Welcome back to Family Feud. If you just joined us, we're in the middle of a feud. The Bracies have struck first, $97. The champs are not on the board. Let's go. Time. Good luck. We asked 100 people this question. The top five answers on the board. Try to find the most popular answer. Name a famous woman anywhere in the world who probably spends a fortune on clothes. Myra.
Nancy Reagan.
She says Nancy Reagan. How about the First Lady? Not there. If you could give me any of those answers, Steve, you'll take control.
Elizabeth Taylor.
Elizabeth Taylor. Let's see lovely Liz. She's there on the bottom of the survey. Go back with your family's braces. You might get the chance to steal. All right, Mark, you're into lovely women? Famous lovely women?
Okay.
No, I was asking. I wasn't saying you are. I don't have any to offer you.
I have a lovely wife.
Okay, that's not the question, but thank you for volunteering that. Can you name a famous woman anywhere in the world who probably spends a fortune on clothes?
Cher.
Cher.
Okay.
She probably spends a fortune, but there's not a lot of clothing there. Let us see if it is there. I think she gets ripped off, you know, $10,000 for this, you know, it doesn't really make it. How about Cher? Not there, that's your first strike. Two more. These ladies will know this. They look lovely. They're into fashion. Name a famous woman anywhere in the world who probably spends a fortune on clothing.
Princess Di.
Oh, gets my vote. Let us see if it's there. How about Princess Di? Number one. 45 people agree with you. Lovely Pam. Welcome again today.
Thank you.
Can you give me an answer?
Joan Collins.
Yeah.
Joan Collins. All right. Let us see Joan Collins. It's there. Two answers up there. Papa.
Has to be Queen Elizabeth.
I don't think it has to be, Ed, because she's a pretty sloppy dresser in my book.
She?
I would never ask her out. And I had the chance a couple times, too.
Good.
All right. If Queen Elizabeth is there, you're going to continue on your way to a clean sweep. If not, it's your second strike. Let's see Queen Elizabeth.
She did.
Ed, I know she catches your eye, Ed, but not everybody. Steve, your family needs you now. You're the champs. Get those big brains working. You want me to read the question again?
If you would, please.
Good stall. Name a famous woman anywhere in the world who probably spends a fortune on clothes. 3 seconds. It's going to be the third. Strike. You took the third strike. Gracies, an excellent opportunity to steal that bank. I'm going to ask you to give the head of your family some suggestions. John, name a famous woman anywhere in the world who probably spends a fortune on clothes.
Jackie Onassis.
Jackie Onassis. Roberta.
Tammy Baker.
Tammy Baker. Lee Ellen.
Linda Evans.
Linda Evans
Linda
and Myra.
Evans.
There are some fine answers there, Billy. You can take any of those, but you can also select your own. What are you going to do?
I got to go with the ladies and say Linda Evans.
You say Linda Evans. If Linda Evans is on that board, you're going to take that bank. If not, it goes to the Holtrust. How about Linda Evans? The brick goes to the Holtrust family. Excuse me, they are in this game. $61 goes to the Holtrust. Let's hear if we hear any of your answers.
Yeah.
Number two, Jackie Onassis. You said that, didn't you, John?
Yeah.
If you'd listen to him, Billy, you'd have that money. Number four, not a real great one. $97 for the Gracies, $61 for the Holtrust. Don't go away, there's a lot more feuding coming. Right now. The champions are down. The Bracies have $97. The Holtrust have $61. All the way to $300. Let's go. Lee Ellen. Mark. Good luck. The top five answers on the board. Name something that you close your eyes to do. We go with Mark.
Kiss.
He says kiss. How about kiss? Number two answer. Lee Ellen. One will beat it.
Sleep.
She says sleep. Let us see sleep. It is the number one answer. The Gracies take the board. Over this way. We will see how you do, Roberta. You look pensive.
I am.
Name something that you close your eyes to do.
The only thing I can think of is to hit the baseball.
To hit the baseball. You close your eyes when you hit the baseball? Let me ask you something, Bertie. Do you strike out a lot?
I'm still thinking.
Do you strike out a lot? You should never close your eyes when you swing at the baseball.
All right.
I'll just assure you right now, this is your first strike. I want you to know that, okay?
Thanks.
She says hitting the baseball. Let us see. Hitting the baseball. You tried.
Yes.
That's right. You have two more chances before they get that chance to steal. John.
Pin the tail on the donkey.
Pin the tail on the donkey.
Good.
Yeah, that's a good one. Good one. All right, we'll see. He says pin the tail on the donkey. Let us see. Pinning the tail on the donkey. Second strike. There are three answers left. We go to the head of the family to turn this around. Billy.
Well, I don't do it personally, but girls put makeup on.
Okay. I do it personally. See? Yeah, a lot of times. All right. Let us see if it's there. You say putting on makeup.
Right.
Close your eyes to do it. If it's there, you're still alive. If not, it's your third strike. They get that chance to steal. How about makeup? Whoa. Now watch these guys work. We'll see why they're the champions if they can capitalize on this. Name something that you close your eyes to do, Pam.
To get a surprise.
A surprise? Julie.
Blink.
To blink.
To make a wish.
To make a wish. Steve?
To play hide and seek.
To play hide and seek. Now, there are four answers there. You can take any of those, Ed. You don't seem real excited about it. You can make up your own.
I did that the last time. It was in trouble.
That's true.
I think I'm going to go with make a wish.
To make a wish. If make a wish is there, as you know, you take that bank. If not, Gracie's take a bigger lead. Make a wish. Braces, take that bank. $178 for the braces. Now, there are three answers that we don't know. Perhaps you know them in the audience. Number three, to sneeze. Number four, to think. Number five, to pray. The Braces, 178. The champ, 61. Let's go. Time for another face-off. Roberta and Julie, very important question. The dollar values on this question are doubled. The top four answers on the board. Name a law many people break. We go to Julie.
Speeding.
Speeding? How about speeding? It is the number one answer. The champs have control. We come down once again to the lovely Pam. Name a law many people break.
Stealing.
Stealing. Let us see stealing. It is not there, surprisingly. One strike, two chances left, Ed.
Income tax evasion.
You said that so definitely.
No question.
No question.
Not this time.
How about income tax evasion?
What?
I'm going to read the question once again. Listen carefully. Name a law many people break. Steve?
The minimum age for drinking.
Minimum age for drinking. If it's there, you're still alive. If not, they're going to get the chance to steal, and they can win with this bank. The minimum age for drinking. Third strike, is it not? We come over to the Braces. This is a big opportunity to defeat the champs. I'm going to read the question, ask you to help the head of the family. Name a law many people break. John.
Full stop at a stop sign.
Full stop at a stop sign. Roberta.
Stop sign.
Same thing. Lee Ellen.
Stop sign.
Stop sign.
I'll go with that.
They've all four said stop sign. Billy, it may be there, it may be not. I don't think they're much help. You have to pick your own. You can pick your own if you want or go with theirs.
I got to go with theirs.
You're going with their stop sign.
Go.
If stop sign is there, you win this game. If not, they take the bank and are still alive. How about stop sign? It's there. I could not believe it. There are two things. Nicely done. There are two answers that we did not know. Two things that we didn't know. Number two, jaywalking. Number three, littering. You have been wonderful champions. $13,638. Thank you so very much. You certainly did a great job this week. Thank you so much. I need two players for $5,000. Who's playing first? John? Myra? First? John off stage. The Braces have won the game. They're playing fast money for $5,000. Now go away. Thank you. thank you for coming back. And if you just joined us, the Braces have just defeated the champions, become the champions. Myra, during the break, you told me something. You have six children.
That's right.
And you're this tiny. I think you deserve a round of applause for that.
Thank you.
All right. You can use this $5,000
sure
and your
can.
Share of it. Good luck. You know how this works. We've taken your brother-in-law, John, off stage. I'm going to ask you five questions. Mm-hmm. You have 15 seconds to answer. Try to give me the most popular answer. If you and your brother-in-law come up with 200 points, you're going to take home $5,000.
Okay.
Right. You have 15 seconds to do so. 15 seconds on the clock, please. The time will begin after I finish reading the first question. Good luck. Where would most women want to subtract an inch?
From their waist.
Name a food that should be bought fresh.
Apples.
A common color for flowers.
Red.
A beverage you drink at the beach.
Water.
A sport with the highest paid athletes.
Football players.
That is five. Turn around. Let us see how you did. I asked you, where would most women want to subtract an inch? You said their waist. Our survey said 49. How about that? Very fine start. I asked you to name a food that should be bought fresh. You said apples. Our survey said 16. Made the survey, 16 people agreed. A common color for flowers, you said red. Our survey said 48. Getting up there, over 113. A beverage you drink at the beach, you said water. Our survey said none. That's okay. You swim in the water at the beach and you drink other things. A sport with the highest paid athletes. You said football. Our survey said 54. 167 points. You're getting up there. Let's cover those answers so her partner has no idea. Go back with your family. Here comes John. John, I got some good and some bad news. Good news is 33 points to win. The bad news is I don't know if there's a lot of number one answers up there. Now, she was telling you she has six children. How many kids do you have?
I have two.
You have two.
We just started.
Well, it looks like you got a good just started? Mm-hmm. When, like yesterday?
Well, no, I think the day before.
The day before. How old are they?
Two and a half and one and a half.
Well, good luck. You're going to split this money five ways? You're going to keep it all, John?
I go home with the pot.
Well, she did 167 points. You need 33. Let's see if you can do your part. Good luck. You know how it works. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. If you hear this sound, it means you have duplicated her answer. And I'll say, try again to give me another answer. It's a little more difficult, so I'm going to give you five more seconds on the clock. 20 seconds, please. Let's reveal the answers once again that his partner gave us. Good luck. Where would most women want to subtract an inch?
Waist.
Try again. Name a food that should be bought fresh.
Eggs.
A common color for flowers.
Red.
Try again.
Yellow.
A beverage you drink at the beach.
Pop.
A sport with the highest paid athletes.
Football.
Try again. All right, that is five. You did it. If you've come up with 33 points, you're going to take home $5,000. Let us see. I asked you, where would most women want to subtract an inch? You said, from their thighs. Our survey said 4. Myra knew waste was the number one answer for 49 people on the survey. Name a food that should be bought fresh. You said eggs. Our survey said 2. Just want to say, John, she had 163 or 167.
Yeah.
Right now you got 6.
Looking good.
I'm hoping for you, pal. I asked you a common color for flowers. You said yellow. Our survey said 31. Okay. I can't believe we did it. John, you pulled that out. Ow, they're hugging me. They won $5,000. I don't believe it. Don't go away. Joining us today, we have a new champion, the Bracey family. They're taking home $5,338, and they're coming back. I'll see you then. I'm Ray Combs for the Family Feud.
some of our departing families will receive Concord's 35mm automatic camera with focus-free lens, pop-up flash, and pocket-sized TEF with built-in Jello lens and flash from Concord Camera. Part code, solid oak parquet floor tiles. Cushion foam backing makes them comfortable and sound-absorbing. They're self-adhesive for easy installation by Hart Code. A gift certificate for Kentucky Fried Chicken. Feel the warmth and taste the goodness of home. Kentucky Fried Chicken is home. What's the secret behind great-tasting Italian meals? Ragu spaghetti sauce. That's Italian. Kool-Aid soft drinks. The taste kids love at a great price. Having kids means having Kool-Aid. New Nabisco frosted wheat squares, crunchy bite-sized, lightly frosted biscuits, and shredded wheat for great nutrition, great taste. From Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.
I was standing right next to him. Could you imagine? I mean, what if I had seen or said something I shouldn't have? Anything could have gone wrong.
That sounds awful.
It was. Don't you bank at United Metro Trust?
Yes, I do.
Lucky you weren't there then, too.
Yeah, lucky.
Oh, look, Carson's putting Brooke in.
So did you get a look at the guy?
Of course I did. I gave the police a full description.